So I've titled this message, The Truth About Losing Your Salvation. And of course, the truth is, you can't lose it. And nevertheless, there are a couple of passages that really scare people when it comes to our salvation. Can we lose it? So this morning, as we look at the truth about losing it or not losing it, we're going to be looking at Hebrews chapter 6 and also Hebrews chapter 10. And my goal is to kind of give us a bird's eye view of both passages and to really get into what the author was trying to say. And as we journey through these couple of scripture passages, we're going to be confronted with two big buts. Have you ever been confronted with two big buts? I mean, that's something that can be alarming. The word but, B-U-T, it means a 180 change in direction. It means, wow, everything that I just heard has a caveat. Everything that I've just been told is now going to be turned around on me, and there'll be a second message. And so what I mean by that is that Hebrews 6 has a big but, and Hebrews 10 has a big but. And when we see what this but is all about, well, then you're going to realize, whoa, it all makes sense to me. Now, let me give you a little preview of coming attractions. We've got a warning in Hebrews 6, and then we've got a, but you believers have a different situation. We've got a warning in Hebrews 10, but then it says, but you believers have a different situation. So that's what I mean by a big but, the word B-U-T staring us right in the face saying, hold on, even though there's this radical warning for those who would reject the gospel, yet there is a different piece of news for us who are in Christ. So that's what we're going to see this morning. We begin in Hebrews chapter 6, and it says this, therefore, leaving the elementary teaching about the Christ, let us press on to maturity, not laying again a foundation of repentance from dead works and of faith toward God. So first of all, you can see this author, this apostle, he wants to get beyond the basics. He wants the audience that he is writing to move along now. And yet, the author of Hebrews is addressing a mixed group. I mean, you better believe that not every Jew was a believer. Not every Hebrew understood the truth of the gospel. And so we had this mixed group, some saved, some lost, some sort of on their way to being saved, teetering on the fence, flirting with Jesus, thinking about Moses, not...